Look at what we do to your brother, Ese. Yo, look at this. It sucks that they don't have these in the dude's form. You know what this is?
That's from
Riverdale.
Oh, yes.
Riverdale, bro. Innocent say I keep a check. She was a bad man, nevertheless. Calling it quits now, baby, I'm a wreck. Crash at my place, baby, I'm a wreck.
What's up, y'all? Hey, guys. We're back at Nuno's house. You already know how it is.
So what we're gonna do is apparently there is a fan-made theatrical trailer for Crisis on Infinite Earth.
Yes, sir.
Yep, and we've heard there's like so many, many people that's gonna be in this. Wait, are they still gonna do like the whole four episodes like per show? Are they
five, including Batwoman. Unfortunately, it won't be including back Ryan, but he is going to make an appearance in this.
All right.
Still don't know which Earth he's going to be from, but hey. Yes. Now they actually confirmed that Lucifer is going to be in this. Cameo that's from the Titans.
Like, is Lucifer even a freaking comic book franchise? As far as I know, it's
isn't
not.
Isn't he DC, though?
I don't know. As far as I know, he's not a comic book character.
You do watch his show, don't you?
Yeah, I love the show, but as far as I know, it's not a comic book character. He's definitely from the Bible, though. All right, show us what we got.
All right,
keep it open mind. We got to support our fellow YouTubers out there.
Keep it open mind because this got a lot of good positivity from this.
All right, I'll keep it open mind. All right, of course,
3, 2, 1. And this shit's over somebody, 5 minutes. So
somebody definitely worked hard on this.
Wait till you see.
Rated S for spoilers. EL edits.
Everything is as it should be.
This is something we'll see in Secret Wars, I bet. Or Marvel, eventually.
Sound like this, yeah.
DC's getting the boss to do it first, though.
Wait, which one is our Earth?
A crisis is coming. The monitor thinks they're facing the
hey.
Of reality.
Actual DC.
I've traveled from my Earth.
Oh, shit.
A crisis is imminent. Someone is coming. Someone far, far more powerful than myself.
Holy this sky. Our the Earth, usual shit. Earth
and these other Earths. 2, 3, 4, 5.
Well, I don't know if Black Lion's in Earth 4. Okay.
The Metal Gear. Clever.
No. Something is coming. Something big. Or someone.
The monitor. You got him to change our destiny somehow. Mm-hmm.
You can't change your destinies, Barry, by being the heroes that you always have been.
Barry's a villain.
So are you.
I heard this theory
that is a well shot scene.
But because of you.
I swear, every crossover always ends with these two having a in the bar, having
those,
a drink.
Yeah, those two are the bestest friends. They built this universe.
Yeah.
If it wasn't for them, we wouldn't have the Arrowverse.
Yeah. But it's just not called the Flashverse when Arrow's gone.
To understand what I'm about to tell you, you need to do something first. You need to believe in the impossible. Can you do that? I got this friend.
Oh my god, that shitty version.
It's pretty good and impossible.
From the other show. From that show. He should look older.
You needed help. In so many ways.
The mouth looks much better.
Where are they? Oh no.
There's that.
You gotta help me save my world.
What's him doing? What's he doing here?
Let's hope he does become Green Lantern.
Oh shit! That would have been so.
Figured you could use a hand. Wait, you're Robin too?
Oh, hell no.
I am. How many Robins are there?
Not enough.
1,000.
Oh,
I came to save my own voice. I came to save my own.
Where did you say you were from again?
Mars, actually.
Batman's another legend.
Batman's the best of the best.
You don't believe Batman's
and he would never give up on Gotham. Neither of them.
No, none of them. How'd you like
Monitor. John, wants to destroy all the Earths in the
John
multiverse.
Stewart, my favorite lantern of all.
We won't. Survival will only be found by knowing your true self.
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit. Kingdom Come.
The black one.
Really?
The first planet that you recover. Starfire, the only Starfire we got.
But eventually everything all
around
will burn.
Beast Boy, Crash. Oh, shit.
Alongside
of you. Aw, oh, listen to you, bro.
Now it's up to you to keep our home safe. My father sent me here to protect this planet. And I will fight you to my last breath.
Where's evil Superman? That has to have an evil Superman, I wish. Constantine, Swamp Thing.
The way you've been using yours tells me you don't have the metal for this.
Where's Joker? There should be a Joker here.
Oh, universe dies. Got the Arrowverse Trinity shit. Oh, damn. They're gonna go all comic book accurate in this, I can tell.
Yeah, damn, that is
what
dope.
What are you doing here?
What's that?
I need your help.
Mike.
I'm listening.
But hold on, we gotta go back to that. I gotta see him again. That's my childhood right there. Kevin Conroy.
Batman the Anime Series, yo.
Who's better than Kevin Conroy? Nobody.
What are you doing here?
I need your help.
I'm listening.
The best Batman ever. Wait a minute. If they have the best Batman ever, where's the Joker? You gotta have the best Joker.
You gotta have Mark Hamill's Joker. Shit.
If they don't have Mark Hamill, it's like my favorite Batman ever. Look, he actually looks like Bruce Wayne. Dang.
And he's confirmed to be older Bruce Wayne in the event.
Oh, man, it would have been awesome to see him in the Batsuit. Oh, man, I really would have loved to see
him. Who knows? Maybe he still can.
And, oh, the actor from Batman Beyond. I wonder if he is going to be playing the guy, you know, Terry McGinnis.
Yeah.
You know who that is, right?
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Like I've been saying, he should appear in Batwoman, if anything.
This makes me excited for the actual thing coming out.
If they're not gonna bring in a Batman to be in Batwoman,
I would hope at least Static Shock.
Oh, we gotta have
a static.
How do you feel if they bring in a live action actor who voiced Static Shock for the Crisis event?
Oh, they can't. Well, why not? Technically, they can, but they can't.
Explain your reason.
Well, the reason is he's mad old. Old Static. Oh, like they ended Static when he was really young. They didn't give him an older version. Well, they did give him an older version, but it was in Justice League. Unless they give us an explanation why he's so old. Oh yeah, I've been doing time travel way before Barry. Like that would have been a gag at Barry. He's like, but I didn't mess up the timeline. Like you, fuck you, you dumbass. I don't fuck with the timeline. Have you ever seen Justice League? Yeah, you know what I'm talking about.
So what you think of all this?
This looks so dope. You see the guy who brought them all together? I would assume he was a villain or some shit. This is so cool. Hey, yo, but look at this well-shot scene, you know, where they were talking in the bar, right?
Yeah, that was from Elseworlds.
Yeah, I know it's from Elseworlds, but dang, that is so well shot. The camera's clean. It doesn't even look like a TV show. It looks like an actual movie.
They almost made this event be close enough to actually be a movie.
Yo, you know what they should do? They actually turn this into a movie and then they post it on Netflix. Like, how dope would that be? Since Lucifer is on Netflix. Like, instead of having this episode per, like, friggin' per episode
shit. And if
it's
gonna be the usual hour episode shit, then I really hope there'll be no interrupted commercials and as usual as that.
Yeah, me too. That's annoying. Having to go through every single show per episode, every crossover, it's annoying. I hate doing that. I want all the, they should make a whole show out of it. DC, like CW crossover or Arrowverse crossovers. Yeah, all of them were like, they all were on CW.
And Michael Keaton's Batman.
Michael Keaton's Batman and Kevin Conroy.
Yeah, you seen the photo, fam? You seen the photo that he's getting engaged to, what's her name from the original Michael Keaton Batman movies? He's gonna get engaged with her. Married.
He's getting engaged to the actress from that movie?
Yeah.
Damn.
How do you feel, bro?
How do I feel? Dude, that is dope, man. Everybody shipped that back in the day.
Finally seeing Sonic continuing from the original Michael Keaton Batman films. Yeah. Now they could just bring the Dark Knight version of Batman into this.
Was it Catwoman? Or was it like the one of the love interests? Because the love interest from the Michael Keaton 1986 is that girl's dead.
Then it could be just Catwoman. I don't know. I forgot the name they put.
Yeah, because Catwoman was confirmed alive. Okay, good. Catwoman. So she's alive. Okay, so that's all the proof I need. Okay, so I would definitely love to see that. I want to see like so many characters. Like there's I know that there's like so many characters that I'm definitely not gonna get. Like, cause you know that'll be so crammed up and it's gonna like fuck up the whole thing.
Already confirmed for the special. I mean, they're really trying to go all out and shit. They might just kill off some iconic characters that we know from the past.
Man. I mean, I don't want to see Kevin Conroy or Michael Keaton. I don't want to see any of them die.
Nah.
They probably will.
Brandon Routh, who played his role as Superman during that one time for Superman Returns or something.
Oh, I love that movie.
He's going to become the Kingdom Come version of Superman.
Okay, to be honest, I don't love him as much as like a lot, but I did like Superman Returns because I saw it as a kid, and it had, and nobody can deny this, Lex Luthor in that movie is one of the best Lex Luthers since the TV
he went all out, he's becoming bald because
going crazy because
like
going,
don't you remember dope. How the original Lex Luthor wouldn't even shave his head to become bald?
Yeah, I know that was the original Lex Luthor. People don't want to remember this, but like in the movie Superman Returns, like he actually had a wig on, like basically making fun of Lex Luthor with the hair, and he was all like, keep that, the rest of it stays. It was really funny, and the little girl screaming and then he's walking away all bald and shit. Basically it was making fun of the first movie.
Do you know of that one-off Birds of Prey show?
I didn't watch it because I wasn't aware.
Because I heard Huntress from that show is gonna reprise her role in this.
But I do know somebody who did watch it. It was my mother.
Really?
Yeah, my mother was watching it. You know, but the thing is, the star of the show, as far as I know, the star of the show was Batman's daughter, and what's her name? And Harley Quinn even made an appearance in there too.
I heard Joker made an appearance too.
I heard, but I didn't see it. I didn't watch the whole show.
Well, I'm about to binge watch it before the event.
I only saw very various glimpses of that Birds of Prey show, because clearly this, the CW and the Arrowverse, they know that show had its fans. I'm wondering who's gonna be the villain, but if I'm thinking correctly, on Crisis on the Infinite Earth, I think the best villain would definitely be Lex Luthor.
All
of them.
Especially since they're planning on bringing him back from the dead.
Yeah, can you imagine 3 Lex Luthors in one movie?
I really want them to bring in Lex Luthor from Smallville.
Like that's how Lex Luthor would win. Lex Luthor would have a chance of winning. He gets like 3 different Lex Luthors, and like he gets like a bunch of different Jokers, a bunch of different like other characters.
How would the other Arrowverse villains play a role in? Huh? I mean, some say say they'll play a role in
the villains that they don't.
League of Doom. Especially with Reverse Flash.
Yeah, like, you know, get the ones that nobody cares about, get them as goons to attack, and it won't actually feel like a bunch of throwaway villains, but like it will, like you will have them mostly as goons, and you get like the ones that people love, the ones that people care about that they know. Like, for example, if Mark Hamill's Joker is gonna be in here, you gotta have the Trickster. You know the Trickster, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because Mark Hamill played the Trickster in Flash. Like so many other villains out there, like especially the ones that people love, you have those guys as the main headaches for the heroes.
Like, yo, I wonder is who is like paying for all of these actors from all of these shows and all and movies at that really to come together? Who's paying for this? Who's doing all this?
They're really getting great amount of budget for this.
Like, yeah,
what especially is their limit?
Yeah,
their maximum.
We know that this is a fan made trailer, but like in actuality, like some of the cameras are really cleaned up. It looks like an actual movie.
I like how they managed to pull in some strings and actually made Christopher Reeve Superman insisted in this.
Yeah.
Rest in peace, bro.
Dang. You know what they can do? Since they have such a budget, you know, for the real thing, they can hit up Michael B. Jordan to actually play Calvin Ellis Superman.
Oh my god, bro.
Like, can you imagine that? Like, he was rumored to be Superman.
Mm-hmm.
He was rumored. It was a rumor. It wasn't for real.
I wouldn't be surprised rumored, if they do that for him.
And then
standalone future Superman movie coming down the line.
And then they get Michael B. Jordan. When Michael B. Jordan, he did an interview saying, he's like, yeah, I would be Superman. Like, but I don't want to be Clark Kent Superman. I want to be Calvin Ellis. Get me Calvin Ellis. I'll be him. Like, he's from another universe.
Would you be comfortable if that was to be Zachary Levi Shazam? Since, like, we should definitely have Shazam be represented in the Crisis event.
That would be dope. But it's still, it's too much. Like
yeah, it's because really
because clearly all these people are gonna try to one-up each other and overshadow one another. Or they can have all these damn characters come together and not have them fight the villains, but fight each other.
Huh? But that's not really we based know for Crisis we on Infinity Earths.
Yeah,
based on
I know.
What's that based on, though?
Huh?
What's that based on? To I have heroes I, fight against each other.
What I can't.
Iconic DC storyline is that?
I can't remember. What's that? What's the name of that video game?
Don't hate me, but I don't really know much DC-related video it's games besides the video. Arkham series.
Bam! Injustice. That's the name of it. Injustice.
Oh, yeah!
That one. Injustice.
Do you see the Arrowverse like adapting the storyline of Injustice one day?
I would hope so, yeah. Or the main DC Extended Universe for the movies.
True.
Oh, yeah. Also, I saw a picture of Pete Davidson on Suicide Squad.
Oh, yeah. They actually revealed leaked some photos of the Suicide Squad. What you think of the outfits?
Yeah, they look kind of weird. Very weird.
I mean, this is James Gunn we're talking.
Like, Pete Davidson is the only one who looks dope.
I mean, this is James Gunn we're talking.
Yeah.
Once I saw that picture, I was like, yep, that's James Gunn. I'm getting some Guardians of the Galaxy feels for this.
Yeah, that's not the feel I want. I want dark James Gunn. Give me something dark, James Gunn. You know,
Brightburn. Come on, fam.
Yeah, something like that. Or give us something dark.
Come on.
BDC.
Joker can be dark. We seen it. It's fucking terrific. Now it's your turn, James Gunn. You know what you gotta do.
Come on, James. We got faith in you. We never hated you. We never lost faith in you, man. You are the man, James. And please don't force this to be a shitty movie because we already know you're still getting paid by Disney. We already know what's up.
Especially since they're bringing a lot of people from Marvel to be in that DC film.
Please don't. What I hope he does is say, fuck you Marvel for firing me. Well, not Marvel, Disney. Because we already know that.
Oh, I hope that he somehow gets away with making a joke like Disney.
Yeah, he's basically saying, this is what you get for firing me, piece of shits. I kill characters that look like your characters.
I really hope he gets away with that.
Yeah, because I heard that Guardians of the Galaxy 3 is going to be his last movie in Marvel. I heard.
For Guardians. I'm not sure for Marvel overall.
Well, let's see what they got up their sleeve.
Shit.
James Gunn, we love you. Crisis on Infinite Earth, this is going to be dope.
Yo, we can't wait to react to the actual trailer when that comes out, which should be out probably by mid-November, if anything, since it's supposed to start in December.
Yeah.
Right. Speaking of Elvers, stay tuned for when we react to. Yeah, that's right, Nuno. We're reacting. We're going to start reacting so then we can do breakthrough after that.
Yep.
The second episode of Batwoman, you already know.
Yeah, that's going to be most likely on Tuesday since it's 8 o'clock now.
Batwoman airs on 9.
Really?
It's Sunday.
Okay. Give me the remote.
You're.
Previously.
Damn, that is
dope. What are you doing here?
What's that?
I'm listening.
Michael Keaton.
Hold up. Wait a minute. Something ain't right.
Michael Keaton.
Michael Keaton.
Michael Keaton.
Michael Keaton.
That's Kevin Conroy.
Ha! Stupid.
Yeah. Oh, shit. Cut that, please. Please cut it. Please cut it. Kevin Conroy. Please cut that part, please. I'm begging you.